Okay, folks, this is part two of interpreting basic EKG. Part two. Now, part one, we talked about just basic anatomy of the EKG and the P wave, PR segment, QRS complex, ST segment, and the T wave. Now we're going to go into the system. The system that I teach, that I've taught for years at PA programs, is RRPPQQ. So you initially look at your rhythm strip, and you're going to go RRPPQQ. Now that you kind of know the anatomy, that's where you start. You run that through your mind. RRPPQQ. So it's rate, rhythm, P wave, PR interval, or PR segment, QRS complex, and the QT interval. That's where you're going to get the right pearls, tools, information to really solve what is this? Where is the heart initially beating from? Is it the sinus node? Is it the atrium? Is it the AV node? Is it somewhere in the ventricles? So what we're going to do is start with the R and R today. Rate and regularity. Now, heart rate. Heart rate is the number of QRS complexes per minute. It's the same as your ventricular rate, and this should be your pulse. Not always. But when you look at your rhythm strip, one of the things you have to remember is that it's an electrical representation of what we hope is happening mechanically with the heart. So if you put someone on a heart monitor and their heart rate on the rhythm strip is 80, and if you take their pulse, you expect it to be 80. That is not always the case, but we expect it to be. You have an atrial rate and you have a ventricular rate. So the atrium of the heart, the top part of the heart, is going to be beating so many beats per minute. And the bottom part of the heart is going to be beating so many beats per minute. Now, we hope they're doing a two-step. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. We hope that's it. One atrial beat to one ventricular beat, and that would be a normal heartbeat or normal sinus beat. So we're going to talk about how to calculate ventricular rates today. Now, there's two different methods that I teach. Two methods. Now, make no mistake about this. This is one of those things that really burns me about education, right? What burns me is to have you have a complete understanding of EKGs, you have to be taught how to calculate heart rate from a rhythm strip, okay? But clinically, we don't do that. We just look at the monitor and say, what does it say the heart rate is going? Now, I've covered telemetry floors for years. I've worked intensive care medicine. So, like, a lot of people that teach EKGs, I mean, they learn from the textbook, and they're good at it. But it's another thing to be a clinician that's really making real life or death decisions based on what you're looking at. And I've been fortunate to have that experience where I look at a rhythm strip, and how often do I calculate heart rates based on rhythm strip? And it is almost never. So I always want to teach people, either to pass their boards or clinicians, the best way to do it with the most bang for the buck, but I have to teach you how to calculate heart rates from a rhythm strip. It's part of the complete knowledge. Now, you have a 6-second strip method or a threesome method. So you have a 6-second method or a threesome method. 6-second method is the least accurate. We count the number of QRS complexes on a 6-second strip and multiply by 10. And it's helpful if you have a really irregular rhythm or a really slow rhythm. So, now, the problem with the 6-second strip method is this. It's the least accurate. It's just the least accurate. If you have a big gap, it can really throw off your heart rate. So this is more of an estimation than an absolute. Now, if you look at the yellow box, red box, yellow box, red box, yellow box. Now, a big box, as you remember from the first video, is 0.2 seconds, a big box. So 5 of them is going to be a second. So the yellow box represents 1 second. The red box represents another second. So we have 6 seconds there, and you count the beats. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in that top rhythm strip above the boxes. Therefore, you can say and estimate the rhythm there or the pulse there, the rate there, to be 50. Now, if you look at the one below it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it also has 50, but notice there's a big gap there, a big pause there. So again, it's the least accurate, okay? But it is still a tool. So when are you going to use this? With real slow heart rates and with irregular heart rates. It's helpful, but it's the least accurate. Now, okay, the threesome method for calculating heart rates means you have to memorize the sequence of numbers. There's no way around this, ladies and gentlemen. If you want to know to calculate heart rates, the 6-second method is a nice conceptual tool that you don't really have to memorize anything as long as you know that 5 big boxes equal a second. Cool? But this, you have to memorize these sequence of numbers, 300, 150, 100, then a second sequence is 75, 60, 50. So it's a threesome method. So you're calculating 3 numbers or you're remembering 3 numbers in 2 different sequences. Okay, so when I look at this rhythm strip here and I want to use this threesome method, I'm going to find one QRS complex that's very close to a thick line, a big line. So I'm looking at where that arrow is, and I'm going to blow it up. So I blow it up, and every big line after that, okay, every big box, you're going to say that's the heart rate if the next QRS complex is there. So if you look at the blue arrow there, that would be 300. You look at the yellow arrow, that would be 150. You look at the black, that would be 100. So this rhythm represents, based on the threesome method, a heart rate of approximately 100. So if I look at this rhythm strip and I'm looking at the red arrow, so I'm looking at one complex that's very close to a thick line, and then I blow that up. So now I do the same thing, the threesome method. So I go five boxes, blue, 300, yellow, 150, black, 100. Ah, see, it's not there. The QRS complex isn't there yet, so I have to keep going to the second sequence. 75, 60. So I look at this, and that QRS complex is very close to the orange line, which represents a heart rate of 60. So this rhythm here is a heart rate of just over 60, about 64. Again, it's an estimation here, but it gives us tools that we can use. Here's another rhythm strip, another example of it. So again, I'm looking at where the red arrow is, and I'm going to calculate that to the next QRS complex. Now, if you look at this rhythm strip, ladies and gentlemen, you see a big goofy beat in the middle. We'll talk about that, a premature beat. There's three different kinds of premature beats. That's a PVC. Now just look at that and note that. When you see a big, goofy, aberrant looking beat, that's classically a PVC. We'll talk about that on a later lecture. But as I blow that up, so I look at my initial red arrow on the top pointing at the QRS complex. I go five boxes out. Blue is 300. Yellow is 150. Black is 100. And now you look at that light blue line. So that's saying that this heart rate is just a little bit less than 100, so it's approximately 94. Again, it's an estimation here, but that's the threesome method. We have the six-second method and the threesome method. Okay, one more. We'll look at this rhythm strip, and we look at the red arrow. Let's blow it up. So 300, 150, 100. Now that you see that light blue arrow, we see that the heart rate here is about 140, about 140 beats per minute. Okay, so this rhythm strip, we're not going to blow it up, but I want you to look at it and know that that QRS complex is right about on the line. So I look at the next dark line, that's 300, next one is 150, next one is 100, next one is 75. You see, hopefully you can see now that the QRS complex is a little bit shy of 75. So this represents a heart rate of approximately 80 with a brief pause in there. Next rhythm strip. So we look at this one. Now, this has got an atrial flutter-like appearance. Now, we'll talk about the different rhythms, the different specific pathological rhythms, but I look at it, and I can't really clearly see a discernible P wave. Actually, on this one, it looks like there's a lot of P waves, which represents atrial flutter. But if you look at the distances between the QRS complexes, it's pretty irregular. Like, the distance between the first one and the second one is wide, when the distance between the second and third one is narrow. So if I do the six-second method, I count the complexes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is telling me the heart rate is approximately 80, okay? It's a tool. Okay, let's look at this one. Let's look at this one. So now, when I look at my, just within the box here, when I look within the box, okay, the very first QRS complex, if you go to the first box with the green arrow, that's 300. You go to the second big box where the blue arrow is pointing to, you see that the QRS complex is on the second big box. Therefore, this represents a heart rate of 150. So our rate, ladies and gentlemen, is either by the six-second method or the threesome method. Now, again, as I promised, if this isn't real clear to you, first step is do a little bit of work independently. See if you can get this to make sense. If you try to do some work and it still doesn't make sense, contact me and we'll get this to work. We'll figure this out. If I have to send you some additional EKG or rhythm strips, or if we have to have a phone call, I'm glad to do that. Or it could be just through some email exchanges. But I promise to respond to 100% of the questions about rhythm strip interpretation. Next, we're going to talk about regularity. So the rhythm regularity. We're concerned about the consistency of the QRS complexes. It's determined by the R to R interval. Now, the R to R interval, distance between should be, the consecutive distance between the QRS complexes should be the same, or it should only be off by 1 to 2 small blocks or less than 10%. Okay? So the regularity means how frequent is the beat. So this is regular. The distance in between my claps are the same. If it was like this, it's It's irregular. The distance is varied, okay? So we have to determine, it's a yes or no question here. Is it regular or not? That's what we're looking for. So what's the distance that's acceptable? 1 to 2 small box or less than 10%. So if we look at the rhythm strip in front of you, 23, 23, 23, 23, 23 and a half, 23 and a half, 24. It's regular. It's off by such a small variation that we're still good with that. So we would call this rhythm regular, okay? Now, what if it's regular but interrupted? So regular rhythm but interrupted by premature beats or pauses. What I like to say, it's regular, but has a funny beat or two. So we look at this one, as we talked about earlier. It's regular. If you look at the distances between the QRS complexes or the R waves, it's the same other than that big, wide, goofy P wave. Now, this is where you can use calipers. You can use a piece of paper and map the distance out. Okay, or you can gestalt it, which means you just look at it and let your eyeballs tell you, hey, I think this is regular. It's most accurate if you use calipers. If you're new, calipers are helpful. Okay, let's look at this one. We have the first R to R distance is 25, second one's 25, third one's 43. Then we go 26, 25, 26. So this is still regular. What I like to teach is, when I teach this in programs, if you have three of the same R to R intervals, you call it regular. It's a good general rule. So we see 25, 25, 25. We have three of them there. Even though one's off, we still call it regular. Now here is a classic rhythm strip atrial fibrillation. But right now we're not worried about that. We're worried about, is it regular or not? So we see 17, 20, 30, 11, 21, 13, 18. That's classically an irregular rhythm that goes hand in hand with atrial fibrillation. So this is a irregular rhythm. So the question is yes or no. Yeah, it's irregular. Yes, it is. So that's the question that we're asking. We're going to ask rate and regularity. Rate is I need a number. Regularity is yes or no. Yes, it's regular or no, it's not regular. Okay? Okay, remember that if we're calculating heart rates that are regular but have interrupted premature beats, we just ignore that beat. Okay, so I look at this rhythm strip. There's a big, fat PVC in the middle. We're looking at the R to R intervals before and after that to say this is indeed a regular rhythm, but there is a PVC. We look at this rhythm strip here, and once again, there's a pause there. We're looking at the rhythm strips and the R to R distance before and after the pause. So again, this is a regular rhythm yet with a pause. Now, let's do some practice here. Let's look at this rhythm strip. First off, if we do the 6 second strip method, we can see the heart rate is about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is about 100, okay? Now look at the R to R interval between the first one, the second one, the third one. So if I look at the R to R interval between the first two QRS complexes, I see the distance is about 2+ small boxes. Then I look at the next one, it's more like 3 boxes. Then I go to the next one, it's clearly down to 2. This is, if you look at this, in a regular rhythm. So this R to R would be rate of 100 and it's irregular. Next rhythm strip. So if you measured the distance there between the R to R's, that would determine regularity. And as a gestalt, it looks regular, but what if we calculated the heart rate here? Looks like it's about 30 based on the 6 second method, okay? Question always is with the bradyarrhythmias, this is a side note, anybody who's bradycardic, you wanna say, are they symptomatic? Okay. Anybody who has a slow heart rate and they're symptomatic, we have to do something with them. If they have a heart rate of 30, but they're completely normal, they're walking, talking, no syncope, no chest pain, no pressure, heart rate of 30, but they look wonderful, treatment is we do nothing. If they look symptomatic, if they have dizziness when they stand, weakness, low blood pressure, chest pain, we would kiss them with atropine, 0.5 milligrams of IV atropine, but we'll talk about that in a later segment. But anybody with symptomatic bradycardia, drug of choice is atropine, and that's your first line therapy. Let's look at this one. Is it regular or not? So if I look at the R to R intervals, as much as it's a fast heart rate and there's a little variability, this to me is a regular rhythm, okay? Because the variability is less than 1 to 2 small boxes or less than 10%. Looking at this rhythm right here, again, we have a pause, but we ignore the pause. So we look at the R to R's before and after the pause. So once again, this also looks like a regular rhythm. So I would say this looks like approximately a heart rate of 50 with a pause, but it is regular. So in conclusion, when you come to your rhythm strip, ladies and gentlemen, first thing you do is calculate the heart rate, either with a 6 second strip method or the threesome method. And then you're going to tell me, is it regular or not? Yes or no. And if you'd like to add a little bit more information like a pause or PVC, that would be helpful. But the R&R is, heart rate and regularity, and the regularity is yes or no. Folks, John Belinsky from See Me for Life. Hopefully these are helping you. Share it with your friends. Pass this on to people so they can learn too. Thanks for watching. I will have my next video up on Monday. Have a great day.